Hello, my beautiful Taurines. Welcome to the Real Tarot 1123. I am doing a general reading for April 29th and 30th. And like I said, these are general readings. Take what resonates with you and leave the rest. Okay. Please email me if you want a personal or a private reading. I'd be more than happy to do that. My email address is therealtarot1123@gmail.com. These cards are showing unbelievable. Oh my gosh, you guys. These cards showed up, have been showing up so often. There's something going on. I think this full moon had played a number on. This was a harsh full moon. The full moon in Scorpio affected all the signs. Affected all the signs. So, and that's why these cards have been showing up for almost every reading I've done thus far. The only one I have left is after you, Taurines, I got the Virgo reading to do and then I'll be done. But these cards have shown up either together or a combination of in every single reading I've done thus far. So this is so weird. So clearly this is concerning the home, the hearth, the security, the having it all type of situation. There's a harsh judgment, a harsh reality, a reality check that's coming into play over here. You are definitely, you know, mourning the loss of something, or you are concerned about something. You want to be alone, think things through. There's a lot of sadness here. You don't know whether to open the gate and walk on. There is definitely anxiety. And then there is eight, which is coming, something is coming to an end. Okay, so definitely something is coming to an end. So, just checking on that. Let's see. Taurus, what this is all about. Go and check your full moon reading, okay? Taurus, this is a Scorpio full moon, right? So the full moon was in your seventh house because Scorpio is your seventh house, right? So if we had a full moon in Scorpio, all seventh house matters. Oh my God, I can't even speak. All, let me start over. Scorpio is your seventh house. We had a Scorpio full moon on the 26th. So if Scorpio is your seventh house, all seventh house matters would have been affected by that full moon. So the seventh house matters are friendships, marriage, partnerships, contracts, relationships, that sort of thing. So go look at your full moon reading and see what I put up over there and see if it correlates to this, okay? And again, if it doesn't make sense, there is no connection over there, and if it doesn't resonate, move on. Not meant for you. So let's see what this is all about. 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. So we have some money, right? There is definitely some money, some security in this nest, this family, this home. There is a m'lady. So this reality check could be something to do with illness. And this feeling sad and lost could almost, it's like an ending of a friendship or a relationship. Definitely there is an enemy there. So maybe that friend is stabbing you in the back. There's a lot of anxiety. And then you have a letter. This is definitely a good letter. Good news, okay? Good news is coming. And then you have an ending, okay? Ending of something, and then you have unexpected joy. So I feel that whatever this is, let's get these together. Let me see if I can half hold them all together. See this? Whatever this is coming to an end for sure. Okay, as is this anxiety brought on by that, because you have some good news coming after all that stress, and you have what is called unexpected joy. Okay, so I'm going to leave it at that, my beautiful Taurines. Even though something is coming to an end, you are definitely going to have something great to look forward to, right? So full moon, you know, is all about ending of things. And new moon is all about beginning something new, planting a seed, that sort of stuff, right? You plant a seed on the new moon and it comes to fruition around the full moon. And alternatively, on the full moon, whatever negative is there, whatever is kind of building up, you know, the stress is building up, it ruptures ultimately at the full moon, it'll blow up. So. Touch, hug often, and you'll get comfort when you need it. That is so nice. This one moved, I'll take that. And it says appreciate. Praise generates praise. Praise. God, I can't even speak. Did I say praise? So that's all I got for you, my beautiful Taurians. So take care, and I will see you on your monthly reading. Bye.